We have already seen how we could show the data entry form for a new customer. We also saw how the validations were working with it. And now it's time to save the customer data into database. That is, we have to handle the HTTP post for the submit button. Let us proceed to do that. This is where we were. Clicking on the save button, it is causing these validators to fire. But if you remember, there is one more thing that we added to the annotations. When we were adding annotations, validations for the customer table, and that was the remote validation. Remote validation for checking whether the email exists in the database already or not. If the customer ID is already in the database, then a message should fire here that email already exists. For that, we had already added a remote validation. We'll first of all code that on the server side, and then we will take up the next steps. This is what I'm talking about. This is your entity models folder, and we added TBL user and file to it. And inside this file, we wrote this: remote is available, home, admin, error message, whatever. That is, there has to be a method called is email available inside the home controller of ADMN area. Let us go to code this one. Fold it and come to the home controller, and we'll start typing it here. Is email available? It receives customer email. Now, this I'll explain in a moment. Let me first complete it. So if it returns false, it means everything was okay. That is, it was not available. This is the completed one. Null is equal to, if it is not found, it will return true. That means the validation succeeds. And if it finds, then it will return false. If it finds, this one will not be null, and BRET will be false. So this is adjustment that you can check for yourself also. Single or default, it tries to search an email called customer email. This one. If it finds one single record, this won't be null and BRET would be false. Otherwise, it would be true and you will get JSON true. So the validation will fail there and you will find a message there. So the basic thing is that in case it finds the email, the validation fails, otherwise it succeeds. Now this customer email parameter name will come from your form. Let me show you the form first, where we were. This is the customer email that will be passed to this one. It will be passed as you type there through an AJAX call that is wired by the MVC framework automatically. And here we had fitted that annotation. This was fitted on customer email. This name, and this name. They all are one and the same. They have to be the same. Now we should now add the HTTP post receiver for the index. So we'll type it. It will receive TBL user from the post request. If model state is valid, then we'll try to store the record to the database. Then we'll store the save the record to the database and present the message record saved and model state dot clear. To be double sure, I would suggest putting a try catch around it. It is generally a good practice so that errors do not occur in your code. Here we can write, we'll take it from here and put it here and put it here. Record not saved. Now let us try to run it and we'll see how things work. Click to login. Create, we'll try a@a.com. So our remote validation is firing. User must be already existing. Let us call, try it with ag@g.com. Phone is, name is AA. And click on save. So this way, this module is completed. In our next lecture, we shall proceed to the next module and see it completed. Thanks.